My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord. The way God works at the family is with His dream, with His promises. Yes, that's what God did to Joseph, that you will be a great man. You will be like the sun and all the stars, your brothers, everybody will worship you. Your sheep will be looking high and all the other sheep, they will be around you. Yes, God had given him a dream. And amidst all the struggle, he kept up the dream of God. Yes, God is taking me. I don't know where I am going. Like Job said, I don't understand what's happening to me. But one thing I am sure, my Redeemer lives. And one day I will see and understand, why did my God allow all these things in my life? Until then, I will move on. Moving on is the power of the dream. We read in the book of Exodus, chapter 14, verse 15. Now, Moses stands before, in front of the Red Sea. Behind him, the sound of the horses and the chariots of Egyptians are heard. In front of him, the Red Sea. The people are crying, we are going to be perished. Moses cries to God. God says, why are you crying? All that you need to do is keep alive the dream that I gave to you. What did the dream I tell you? My name is I Am. I am sending you. It is I am sending you. God gave a dream. I will give you the land of milk and honey. And I am my name, and I will go before you. God gave them the dream. They were the slaves. They have to get up in the morning till the night, they have to work. God gave them a dream. You and your family will be saved. The name of your God is a savior, and the saving act takes place through many, many ups and downs. You got to go through desert, you have to go through valleys, you have to go through the sea, you have to go through the rivers, but you will reach Canaan. The dream is you will reach the land of Canaan, but you have to go through valleys, you have to go through the enemy's swords, you have to go through desert full of snakes. You have to go through Red Sea, Jordan River. These are part of life. Don't look at the sea and get stuck up. God said to Moses, read Exodus chapter 14, verse 15.
Then the Lord said to Moses.
Then the Lord said to Moses.
Why are you crying out to me?
Why are you crying out to me? I have given you already the vision. Why are you crying to me? Yes.
Tell the people of Israel to go forward.
Okay, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The word is go forward. Go forward. Don't get stuck up. Go forward. Aage padna, tum aage chalo. Nahi rukna, aage chalna. Yes, the word the Lord says is go ahead. Go forward. The dream. You have to hold on. If your family has to live according to the Bible, according to the scripture, many children, many families are broken because they don't understand how God led. God says when God gives the family, God brings His people together, there will be many obstacles, many struggles, many pain. But that is the part of life. there is no night which cannot be dawned. There is no night which cannot be dawn. Dawn, you know, DAWN, dawn means becoming morning. No night that cannot become a morning. Yes. No war cannot be conquered by the children of God. God said, go forward. Just look at that next person and say, God says,
go forward.
In your family.
Many obstacles will come.
Mountains may come.
Red Sea may come.
Valleys may come.
Jordan River may frighten you.
But God says,
I
have given you vision.
I have given you vision.
I have given you a dream.
I have given you a dream.
Aage chalna.
Piche na dekhna.
Aage chalna.
Hallelujah.
I think in Kongani they say makana koko. Praise the Lord. Don't look back. Go ahead. Go forward. It is this mission made Moses to go ahead. In life, God gives to each one of us the dream. It is with this dream we can conquer the fear, the unbelief, the perfectionism. Oh no, it has to be like this. If I have to go, if it has to be like this, people will be talking about perfectionism. Satan will bring, if this is not there, how can you go? What foolish you are. We have to tell them, nothing is impossible for God. God tells, go forward. How can we go forward? Red Sea is inside. We are going to be drowned. God says, go forward. Hold on to that vision. Hold on to His word. Proceed. This is the way God led His people. Yes. With God, I am a hero. Without God, I am a zero. This is what Joseph proved in his life. His brother sold him. The Egyptian house. The Egyptian saw God in Joseph. Now, usually the servants are frightened of the master. But when you move with a dream, the master is frightened of the servant. Usually in other places, the servant respects the master. Here, Joseph was given honor and respect. And he gave the whole thing work for Joseph to do. Even there, the disturbance of the enemy, the lust came in, disturbed Joseph, threw in the jail. The Bible says the jailer found something different in Joseph and showed favor. God's favor will be on you when you move with the dream of God. Look at the neighbor and say, when you move with God, even jails may be on your way. But God's favor will bear you. God's favor will carry you. Hallelujah. His mother, his father gone. Brothers are gone. Working place, he was thrown away into the jail. Even the friend in the jail, when he explained the dream, Joseph said to the friend that you are going to be released soon. The king is going to release you, and the king is going to make you to work in his own place. Remember me. Man is man. He was released, but he forgot Joseph. But God works in his beautiful time, according to his dream. When Joseph reached 30 years, for a ruler in Egypt, he should be minimum 30 years. And when Joseph reached the 30th year, the dream which he had as a little boy is fulfilled. He was thrown away from the home when he was 17. After 13 years, the dream is fulfilled. And he became the ruler of the great Egypt. And he became the savior, saving thousands of families. When you and I have the dream of joining with our master, our family is basically God has united us, a man, woman and children, to join with the master to fulfill his dream of bringing life and salvation to the world, to our neighborhood, to our family members. If you don't pray, if you don't give hope, who will give the hope? You are the dreamers. While everybody speaks about their disturbances, everybody speaks about their darkness, everybody speaks, we have lost everything, we have lost our life, we have lost our hope, we have lost our finance, we have lost our children. You say, light is still waiting for you. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1 and 2. The whole world lies in darkness. The people of the world are covered with the darkness. And God has kept you in that family which is going through trials one after another to give the light. But Satan will make you also to be part of the darkness. Then your dream is gone. The moment you lose the dream, your life is gone. Your purpose is gone. Your mission is gone. Your family has to be the family of God. Your family has to fulfill the dream of God. That's why God has called you. Keep alive the dreams higher.